So we continue our discussion of basic principles and concepts, definitions in thermodynamics with our discussion of review problems. And this time we will talk about density, specific volume, specific weight, and pressure. So let's go ahead with our first problem. We have the mass of a fluid system is 0.311 slug and its density is 30 pounds per cubic feet. And G is equal to 31.90. So let's go ahead and write those given. So we have mass is equal to 0.311 slug. Density is equal to 30 cubic feet per pound, pound per cubic feet. So if that is density, then therefore the pound there is automatically pound mass. Just take note of that. And then G is equal to 31.90 feet per second square. So first, find the specific volume. So this is the specific volume is fairly easy to be found because specific volume is simply the reciprocal of your density. And density is also the reciprocal of the specific volume. So that is just simply 1 over 30 pound mass per cubic feet. So therefore, specific volume is equal to 1 over 30. So 1 divided by 30. So that is 0.0333. So therefore, the unit is now cubic feet per pound mass. Okay. So next, letter B, specific weight. So specific weight, okay, is equal to density times G over K. And we are given our density. So density is 30 pound mass per cubic feet. G is 31.90 feet per second square. And then K, so the appropriate K here is 32.174 pound mass feet over pound force second square. So here, your feet per second square will be cancelled out. Pound mass will be cancelled out. And the final unit is in pound force per cubic feet. Okay? So, specific weight, this symbol is called gamma. Just take note of that. So, I have 30 times 31.9 divided by 32.174. And the answer is 29.74. So, let's write that down. 29.74. So, as I've said, pound force per cubic feet. Okay, so we're done with letter B. Then letter C, what is the total volume? So we will derive that from our density. So density is equal to mass over volume, and this is total volume. So the difference between specific volume and total volume is the total volume, first of all, has a symbol which is capital V, and this is small letter V. Now, specific volume is, as you notice here, now specific volume is cubic feet per pound of mass, okay? So, that's why it's specific, because it's per pound of mass. Now, volume is just cubic feet, okay? It's just in cubic feet. So, we are given the density, so therefore, we can actually derive for the volume here, and volume would be equal to mass over density. So, mass, our mass is equal to 0.311 slug, and density is equal to 30 pound mass per cubic feet. So, we need to convert either the slug here, or the pound mass in the denominator. So, let's just say I convert the pound mass in the denominator. So, the conversion that I will make is 32.174 pound mass is equal to 1 slug. Okay? So the okay, this was reversed. This should be one slug is equivalent to 32.174 pound mass. Okay, the conversion is correct, but the placement is wrong. So pound mass will be cancelled out, and then slug is cancelled out, leaving us with only cubic feet. Okay. So volume is now equal to 0.311 divided by 30, then 30 divided by 32.174. Okay. So the answer is 0.3335. Okay. 0.333334. Okay. Can have that. 3335 or 3334. Okay. So in the previous answers, we always have four significant numbers. So it's also appropriate that we make it four. So this is 0.335 cubic feet. So that is our total volume. We now go to our problem number two. So problem number two, we have a cylindrical drum, 2 feet in diameter and 30 feet in height, is filled with fluid whose density is 40 pounds per cubic feet. Okay? Determine letter A. So let me just correct this. This is not 30 feet in height, but instead just 3 feet in height. Okay? 3 feet in height. So not 30 feet. Is filled with fluid whose density is 40 pounds per cubic feet, and a total, determine the total volume of the fluid, its mass in pounds in slug, and its specific volume and specific weight, given that G is equal to 31.90 feet per second squared. So we have a drum. Let's just visualize the problem first. We have a drum, cylindrical drum, and then it has a height of 3 feet. So this is the height. Height of 3 feet. And a diameter of 2 feet. Okay? So given the height and the drum, given the height of the drum and the diameter of the drum, we can solve later on for the volume of the drum. So the density of the fluid inside the drum is equal to 40 pounds. So this is pound mass per cubic feet. Okay? So letter A, find the total volume of the fluid. So that is what I am talking about. That we are given the dimension, we can solve for the volume of the drum, and therefore the volume of the fluid inside the drum, because a fluid takes the shape of the container. Okay, in this case, the drum. So, volume is equal to area of the base. So, our base here is circular because it's a cylindrical drum. So, pi d squared over 4 and then multiplied by the height. So, area of the base times height. So, we have pi, our diameter is 2. So, 2 squared over 4 times 3. Okay, so this is both are in feet. So, we will have a cubic feet as our answer. So, actually, before I calculate that, 2 squared is 4, so numerically that cancels out. So we will simplify 3 times pi. Okay, 3 times pi. So that is equal to 9.42. Okay, 9.42 cubic feet. So that is letter A, that is the volume of the drum. Letter B, it's mass in pounds and in slug. So if we are given the density and we have already solved for the volume, therefore we can simply solve for the mass using mass over volume is equal to density. Therefore, mass is simply density times the volume. So mass is equal to density is 40 pound mass per cubic feet times the volume, 9.42 cubic feet. Now we have to find the mass in pounds. So this would give us the mass in pounds. And then later on, for the slugs, we simply have to convert our answer. So we have 40 times 9.42. So the answer is 376.8. Pound mass. Okay? And then 376.8 pound mass, we will simply convert that, and we have been using this conversion for quite some time now in a previous problem as well. We have 32.174 pound mass is equal to 1 slug. Okay? So pound mass cancels out, and we now have the mass in pounds. Okay, so 376.8 divided by 32.174. And our answer is 11.71. So mass is equal to 11.71. Okay, let me just check 11.71. 11.71 slugs. Okay, so that is our letter B. Letter C, find the specific volume. So again, the specific volume is simply the reciprocal of our density. So for letter C, specific volume is simply 1 over rho, and our density is equal to 40 pound mass per cubic feet. So 1 over 40. So specific volume is 0.025. You can just go ahead and calculate that mentally. Okay, so letter D, finally. The problem, it's specific weight. And G is equal to 31.90. So letter D, specific weight, gamma is equal to rho G over K. So density is equal to 40 pound mass per cubic feet. G is equal to 31.90 feet per second square. Okay, so the unit that we want to solve it for is, of course, specific weight is pound force per cubic feet. Okay. So our case here should be equal to 32.174 in order to obtain pound force. So that is pound mass feet over pound force second square. Okay? So feet per second square will cancel out. Pound mass will cancel out, and the remaining unit is pound force per cubic feet. So specific weight is equal to, so we have 40 times 31.9, then divided by 32.174. So the answer is 39.66. 39.66 pound force per cubic feet. Okay? So let's go ahead to our with our problem number 3. So problem number 3 would be about pressure. Drag that problem there. Okay. So problem number 3, a weatherman carried an aneroid barometer from the ground floor to his office atop the Sears Tower in Chicago. On the ground level, the barometer read 30.15 inches of mercury, absolute. And topside, it read 28.607 inches of mercury, absolute. So assume that the average atmospheric air density is 0.075 pounds per cubic feet. Estimate the height of the building. So let's say that this is our building. Okay. And the pressure here at the top of the Sears Tower or the building is equal to 28.607 inches of mercury. While at the bottom, or let's just say piece of O, so it's equal to 30.15 inches of mercury. Now, the average atmospheric air density is equal to 0.075 pounds per cubic foot. Okay, so the formula that we are going to use here is simply delta P is equal to rho G H, where H is the height of the building. Okay, so height is equal to, from this formula, delta P over rho times G. Okay, so delta P is the change in pressure. Okay, so let us first solve for that. Take note that pressure decreases with the altitude, so that's why the pressure at the bottom or at the ground level is higher than the pressure at the top. So delta P is equal to, so we have P sub O minus P, P sub T, pressure at the top of the building. So 30.15, they're both in inches of mercury and they're both absolute pressure. So no problem with that. There will be no problems yet in converting. So delta P is equal to, so we have 30.15 minus 28.607. So the answer is equal to 1.543. Now, since this is in inches of mercury, and our units are in pounds and feet, no? English, it's in English unit, we would want to convert this first, okay? So let's just say we convert this to PSF, pounds per square foot. So we will have to multiply 2116.8 pounds per square foot, pound force, that is pound force because that is pressure per square foot, and this is equivalent to 29.92 inches of mercury. By the way, both of this pressure are mean sea level pressures, and therefore they are equal, no? So we can use it as conversion factors. So inches of mercury cancels out, and we now have delta P. We now have delta P in the PSF. So 1.543 times 2116.8 divided by 29.92. So we have 109.17. Okay, round that off. PSF. Okay, or this is pounds per square foot. Okay, so delta H, height, we have derived that. And it is equal to delta P over rho times G. So delta P is 109.17 pound force over square foot. Average density is equal to 0.075. This is pound mass per cubic feet. Okay? So remember, you cannot cancel pound force and pound mass. Those are two different quantities. Okay? And then G, our gravitational acceleration. So let's just assume that standard gravitational acceleration is assumed here. So it is 32.174 feet per second square. Okay, So we need to have a proportionality constant or K so that our units will all be cancelled out. Now, here we have delta P is equal to rho GH. Let's go ahead and divide K. Okay? So that's the correct formula, rho GH over K. Whenever there is G, there's oftentimes there will always be a K, okay, as the proportionality constant. So therefore, H here, H would be equal to delta P over rho G, then we multiply K, okay, delta P times K over rho times G, all over rho times G. So we need to multiply K here to delta P. So since this is in pound mass, no, the K is 32.174 as well. So pound mass feet over pound force second square. Okay, if the mass is in slug, then K is simply 1, slug feet per pound force second square. So feet per second square will be cancelled out. Pound force is also cancelled out. Pound mass is cancelled out. And we have here cubic feet over feet square. Cubic feet over feet square or square feet. So therefore, only feet would be left, okay, as our h, as the height, which is appropriately so because the height is a dimension of length. So let's go ahead and calculate that. We simply need to calculate these two. We simply need to divide because these two are numerically equal. Okay? So 109.17 divided by 0.075. So the answer is 1455.6. 1455.6 feet. Okay, so that is the estimation based on the pressure difference from atop of the tower and on the ground. The pressure difference from the ground and atop of the tower. So, last problem. Let's, for the last problem, we will convert pressure. Different quantities, so to say, of pressure, different readings. So we have convert the following readings of pressure to kilopascals absolute. Okay? Kilopascals absolute. Assuming that the barometer reads 760 millimeters of mercury. So the 760 millimeters of mercury, which the barometer read, is actually our atmospheric pressure. Okay? So that is our P sub O. Atmospheric pressure, 760 millimeters of mercury. Okay? Now, before I solve this problem, keep in mind that there are two basic formulas for getting the absolute pressure. So, one is P is equal to P sub O plus P sub G. Okay, where P sub G is the gauge reading. So as you can see here, we have A, B, C, D, and E. Those are all gauge reading. But if the given is a gauge reading which is vacuum, then therefore the formula simply becomes P sub O minus P sub G. Okay, so just take note of these two formulas. So for letter A, let's apply the formula, those two formulas. We have 90 cm of mercury gauge. So therefore, we will use the first one. Okay? The absolute pressure is equal to P sub O. So this is always 760 millimeters of mercury plus 90 centimeters of mercury. So we need to convert one. So let's say I converted 760 millimeters to centimeters. So we simply divide 10 and that would become 76. Okay? So inches, centimeters of mercury. plus 90 centimeters of mercury. And this would be 90 plus 76. So 166 centimeters of mercury. Now, how will we convert 166 centimeters of mercury to absolute pressure, to kilopascals? So the conversion would be 101.325 kilopascal is equal to 76 centimeters of mercury. Okay, again, these two are sea level readings of the standard sea level readings for pressure. So 166 times 101.325 divided by 76. So we have 221.32. Let me check that again. 221.32 kilopascals. Okay. Letter B. So we have for letter B, 40 centimeters, but this is vacuum pressure. Centimeters of mercury, vacuum. So the formula that we will use here is P, absolute pressure, is equal to P sub O minus P sub G. So P is now equal to, again, P sub O is 760 millimeters of mercury. And this is in centimeters, so let's just go ahead and put 76 centimeters of mercury. So minus 40 centimeters of mercury. And our P will be 76 minus 40. So it's 36. And convert that to kilopascals. So 101.325 kilopascals over 76 centimeters of mercury. So 36 times 101.325 divided by 76. So we have 47.996, or you can also answer 48. If you want. Okay, 48 kilopascals. So letter C. For letter C, we have 100 PSIG. So this is in PSI, gauge pressure. So the equivalent of, we have to convert first P sub O. Okay. Our P sub O are given is 760 millimeters of mercury. And actually, that 760 millimeters of mercury is equal to 14.7 PSI. Okay? So, to get P, so since this is a gauge, not vacuum, then we have P sub O plus P sub G. Okay? So this is 14.7 PSI plus 100. Okay, so let me write 100 first, just to follow the pattern of the formula. So 100 PSIG, or I should write 14.7. So the first one was correct. Okay? So we have P is equal to 14.7 PSI plus 100 PSI G. So P is equal to 147, 100 or 114.7 PSI. So this will now be absolute. Okay? So convert this PSI to kilopascals. So 101.325 kilopascals over 14.7 PSIA or PSI. So 114 times 101.325 divided by 14.7. So the answer is 790.61. KPa. Okay, so finally, for our letter D, we have 8 inches of mercury vacuum. 8 inches of mercury, which is vacuum. So the formula that we will use for our absolute pressure is P sub O minus P sub G. Our P sub O is 76, right? In P sub O is equal to 760 millimeters of mercury. So, in order to add that, we must convert that to inches of mercury. And 760 millimeters of mercury is also 29.92 inches of mercury. Okay? So, P is equal to, so P sub O, 29.92 inches of mercury minus 8 inches of mercury. So 29.92 minus 8, we will have 21.92 inches of mercury. Convert that to pascal, so multiply 101325 kPa over 29.92 inches of mercury. Okay, so inches of mercury cancels out. Final unit is kilopascals. So P is equal to, let's get our calculator. We have 21.92 times 101.325 divided by 29.92. So we have 74.23 kPa. Okay. So, oh, we still have one more, letter E, 76 inches gauge. So last problem. I thought we are already done. So letter E is 76 inches of mercury gauge. So this is simply P sub O plus P sub G. And P sub O is 29.92 inches of mercury plus 76 inches of mercury. So that is 76 plus 29.92. So we have 105.92 inches of mercury. And then multiply 101.325 kilopascals over 29.92 inches of mercury to convert. So inches of mercury cancels out and we have kilopascals as our final unit. So, let's calculate that. We have 105.92 times 101.325 divided by 29.92. So, we have 358.70 kilopascals absolute. So, that's for the all the problems, no? That's the problems that I have discussed regarding pressure, specific volume, density, and specific weight.